So I wanted to take a few minutes with this video to talk about four interesting PlayStation 5 stories, and if you could hit that like button on the video, thank you to those that do it, and as always, it's very much appreciated. Now, the four stories I wanted to talk about in this video includes a new report on Silent Hill that comes off the heels of new official news that just came out this morning. PlayStation 5 DualSense upgrade comes to a new PlayStation 5 remastered title, Ghost of Tsushima getting remastered, and Sony's targeted strategy that reveals an interesting future for the company. First, let me know if you'd replay Ghost of Tsushima if it was remastered for the PlayStation 5 or not. I'm personally interested in the expanded content, but remembering how great Ghost of Tsushima was on PlayStation 4 and how Miles Morales was upgraded on PlayStation 5, we might get a nice jump in visuals. Add to that DualSense support, and I'm probably playing this game again, but of course that's just me. So comment below, would you replay Ghost of Tsushima if it was if they made a full PlayStation 5 version or not? Let me know down in the comments below. Now, diving into the first story of the video, Ghost of Tsushima Director's Cut. So the story here is pretty simple. Ghost of Tsushima has a Director's Cut version that has recently been rated by the ESRB. For people who don't know, when a game gets rated, it usually means it's not far off from a release, which sounds like this Director's Cut could be dropping later this year. The big part about this story is that we recently, of course, heard rumors that a Ghost of Tsushima standalone expansion was in the works called Ghost of Ikishima. This game would be in the same lanes as Uncharted Lost Legacy and Spider-Man Miles Morales, meaning it would be an 8 to 10 hour experience, but considering it's an open world title, it could easily be longer than that, 15 hours possibly. Seeing this director's cut seems to add more weight to these expansion rumors, since a director's cut, of course, usually has more content than the original version of whatever medium it might be. So we might get a combo pack with both Ghost of Tsushima upgraded full for the PlayStation 5, similar maybe to Spider-Man PS4 remastered with DualSense support and everything, and it comes packed with this expansion for a full price, similar to the Spider-Man Miles Morales Spider-Man PS4 remastered combination, or you can buy this expansion on its own for a reduced price, similar again to Miles Morales from last year. When I covered the Ghost of Ikishima story on one of my previous videos, I mentioned that a Ghost of Tsushima remaster of sorts seems likely, and this looks to be it. Now, diving into the second story of the video, PS5 DualSense upgrade for a new remastered title. So, A Plague Tale: Innocence, the confirmed remaster is set to possibly come to PlayStation Plus next month, according to rumors, will be getting a PlayStation 5 DualSense support upgrade. Reading from Gaming Bolt, speaking to GameSpot, Focus Home Interactive PR strategist Julie Caraniro, hopefully I said that correctly, confirmed that the game will indeed support DualSense's haptic feedback. We can say that A Plague Tale: Innocence will feature faster load times, audio enhancement, DualSense features, i.e. haptic rumble sync with 3D sound and adaptive triggers, and cross progression, Caraniro said. I'm a fan of DualSense, as you guys already know. I've talked about how much I love it on Twitter, on here, on YouTube, and A Plague Tale: Innocence will be interesting to play using those features if done well. I expect feeling things like the rats around you when they get closer, maybe some haptic feedback there, and throwing rocks will have, you know, a bow and arrow type of feel when you're just aiming and taking that shot with the adaptive trigger support, things like that. That's what I expect from this game, and if it's done well, it could be very, very good. But you guys let me know if you're going to play A Plague Tale: Innocence remastered or not when it potentially drops on PlayStation Plus next month. Let me know down in the comments below. Now, diving into the third story of the video, a new report on Silent Hills based off of recent news that just came out this morning. So this isn't the Silent Hills title many of us on PlayStation have been waiting for. This is another Silent Hill title set to be made by the people who made the medium that launched earlier this year on Xbox and is coming to PlayStation later this year. Reading from Video Game Chronicle, Konami and Blooper Team have signed a new strategic cooperation agreement that will see the companies create games together. The new partnership between the Silent Hill publisher and the medium developer will include jointly developing selected content and exchanging know-how, according to a statement released by Blooper Team. In a separate press release, Konami said it was excited to work with Blooper Team and other highly regarded development partners to produce games from existing and new IPs. According to people with knowledge of Bloober's plans, one of the projects it's working on is Silent Hill related. So we've heard that there was potentially a Silent Hill game being worked on at Bloober Team. This was rumors before, but with this confirmation of the partnership, it's seeming pretty much the case. VGC here also seemingly confirms that one of the titles of this partnership is Silent Hill. I personally want that Silent Hills project that Kojima worked on, of course, but who's to say that Bloober Team won't make something amazing? VGC also reminds us that another Silent Hill project is being worked on by a prominent Japanese developer, and this is the one that we've been covering so far. Either way, it seems like a lot of Silent Hill is on the way. Now, diving into the final story of the video, Sony's targeted, very focused strategy. Herman Hulse recently sat down with GQ Magazine after acquiring Housemarque and said this: "We're very selective about the developers that we bring in. Our last new acquisition was Insomniac for $229 million in 2019, which has worked out very well. I'm always looking for people that have a similar set of values, similar creative ambitions, and work very well with our team that we can further invest in and help grow as creators. It's not like we're going around and just making random acquisitions. They're very, very targeted acquisitions of teams that we know well. The amount of collaboration between our external development group and Housemarque on the technical side, the production management side, and even on the creative side has been so deep. So for us, it just makes so much sense to do that." So Sony's buyout approach is very targeted. This is something we've known, that Sony is very selective on who they buy. And just like Insomniac, it seems to be studios that they've worked with a lot and studios that have produced high quality products. The interesting part for me here is that this makes it seem like studios like Kojima Productions, Haven Studios, Firewalk Studios, etc., could all be bought out by Sony at some point if things work out well. These are all studios that Sony has helped start up and is building up right now, so it seems like a likely or a possibility that some of these studios might be picked up by first party. We'll of course see if that happens, but you guys let me know if you think a studio like Kojima Productions would be bought out by Sony or not. Let me know down in the comments below. And if you guys did enjoy this video, please hit that like button, as it always helps, and subscribe if you're new. I got new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and now I'll check you guys out on the next one. And welcome back to the after show. This is the part of the video where we have a little fun down in the comments below. If you're old, welcome back. If you're new, welcome. For today's thing, what I want you guys to do is to body, obliterate, destroy, and overall harass the comment section with the Sony bullseye strategy. Obviously, this is in reference to what we just heard from Herman Hulse and how Sony is very targeted and focused when they try to acquire new studios. They have to be studios that they have a relationship with, a very deep relationship with, and it looks like Sony's already laying out the groundwork for future potential purchases. But if you're excited for the Housemarque and Bluepoint buyout and their future titles, destroy the comment section with the Sony bullseye strategy, and I'll definitely heart those comments like I always do, because I appreciate everybody who stays to the end of my videos. And now I'll check you guys out on the next one.